Good day, everyone. This is Jason Santos, an MBA and a Google Certified Educator. And for today, I'm going to discuss the fundamentals of accounting for senior high school students. So let's get started. That we will be covering here, lahat ng laman ng discussion na to, were taken from DepEd's MELCS or MELCS, the most essential learning competencies. So for this discussion, I will just be covering week one, which includes the definition, nature, function, and history of accounting, as well as the external and internal users of accounting information. Now let's go over the definition of accounting. So accounting is the process of recording financial transactions pertaining to a business. Now let me try to underscore the term recording, no? So when we say recording, your job or trabaho mo is to record, isulat, no, to write down, not to analyze, not to make decisions, because hindi naman ikaw yung financial officer, and it's not your duty to use the money, no. In fact, you will not be touching money. You will just be recording. So let's get that straight, no, as early as now. Ang trabaho mo lang dito ay mag-record if you wanted to be an accountant. No. Accounting process includes summarizing, analyzing, and reporting these transactions to oversight agencies, regulators, and tax collection entities. So these are a couple of establishments and agencies that you would have to report on or present your accounting information, which we will be discussing more in detail later. The financial statements used in accounting are a concise summary of financial transactions over an accounting period, summarizing a company's operations, financial position, and cash flow. So, the accounting information daw kasi, it is a position or it is a reflection of the true state of a business, no? Pwede magsinungaling yung mga managers, or they can try to hide details, but the numbers do not lie, you know? Or the numbers will give you a real idea whether the business is doing good or the business is losing money. So that's what accounting is all about at a glance. Now, a lot of students are really interested in taking accountancy because of the financial rewards, especially when you started getting hired and going in the job, ano, or taking on the profession. So for example, when you become a CPA, your starting salary will be 33,731 per month, no? And if you're a starting bookkeeper, your salary is 17,300 per month. Mas magkaiba yung trabaho ng CPA and bookkeeper. Bookkeeper are just again entrusted with basic accounting tasks, but when you are a CPA or a public accountant, you have bigger duties to fulfill. So we will touch on that later on. And then here are some of the accounting companies, the top 5 accounting companies in the Philippines. You have SISIP and Goris, or the SGV company. It's an international company. Manabat, Delgado, Amper and Company. Isla Lipana, no, Manabat San Agustin. And then BDO Alba Romeo. So these are accounting firms or accounting giants in the Philippines. And something that you could look forward to when you take on the profession. Now, when you become an accountant, there's a specific set of rules that all accountants follow, regardless of your nationality, your geographic location. Kahit nasa Philippines ka, you're in America, or you are somewhere else, you know what GAAP is all about, or the GAAP, the generally accepted accounting principles. So it is a collection of commonly followed accounting rules and standards for financial reporting issued by the FASB or the Financial Accounting Standards Board. So there is an accountancy standards. No, the acronym is pronounced as GAAP or GAAP. Specifications include definitions of concepts and principles as well as industry specific rules. So again, no, this is very specific regardless of where you are. The accounting principles do not change regardless of your location. So even if you move into the US or you move into Canada or you move into Japan, pare-pareho lang kayo nang gagamitin na accounting principles. So what are those principles? There are actually four, no? Objectivity, materiality, consistency, and prudence. So when you say objective, there must be a certain goal when you are doing an accounting statement or a financial statement. It has to be very material, right? It has to prove facts. It needs to be consistent. So if you have a balance sheet, that must jive with your income and loss statement and your statement of cash flow. So on and so forth, dapat pare-pareho yung content niya. And lastly, it must be prudent. So accounting has been there for a very long time. Ano? In fact, if you would try to trace back the history of accounting, you can look at it during the time of Mesopotamia, Egypt, and Babylon. And even during the Roman Empire, the government has detailed records of their finances. So lahat ng pinagkakagastusan nila, even during the Roman Empire, it is recorded. It is in the books, so nakasulat siya. So Luca Pacioli is considered as the father of accounting and bookkeeping due to his contributions to the development of accounting as a profession. So Luca was in charge of setting the standards. Ano, siya yung nagtakda ng mga standards when it comes to accounting. Thus, him being called the father of accounting. An Italian mathematician and friend of Leonardo da Vinci, Pacioli, published a book on the double entry system of bookkeeping in 1494. So throughout your study of accountancy, paulit-ulit na lalabas yung system of what you call as double entry. Dalawang beses ini-enter. Debit and credit, no? Two financial statements. Balanced, no? So lahat yan, later on, you will see as you progress in the study. The reason why it has to be double, no? Just to give you an idea, is that you need to be very consistent. Kagaya ng sinabi natin kanina sa GAAP, kung ano yung nakikita ko sa kaliwa, dapat ganun din yung nakikita ko sa kanan. Ano? It has to be very consistent. It must jive together. And then by 1880, the modern profession of accounting was fully formed and recognized by the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales. So by that time, it was already formalized and it became a worldwide recognized standard. So now we go to this. Why do we need accountancy? Who uses accounting information? So there are actually two categories wherein we could put those people. Meron tayong tinatawag na internal users, and then we also have what we call as external users. So when you say internal users, by the term itself, internal, nasa loob ng company, they are what you call as the internal, because they need the information in order for them to validate what's going on and for them to know the position of the company. Like for example, owners, no? Number one, of course, the owner would like to see what's happening. Gusto ko makita, I want to keep record of everything. Lahat ng ginastos natin, lahat ng pera na lumabas, lahat ng pera na pumasok, so on and so forth. Of course, when you are the owner, you are just looking at the top level, no? You will just be looking at some of the summaries. Hindi mo na kailangan yung highly detailed. Now, the highly detailed portion goes to the managers. Now, if you are the manager, ikaw yung mas kailangan nakaalam ng bawat detailed portions of your accounting report. Right? Because you will be reporting to two people. You will be reporting to your owner, and then you will be reporting to your employees. Now, finally, for the employees, accounting information is a source of validation. Like, let's say there's an annual report in front of the entire company population, no? Lahat ng mga tao. So the managers and even the owners would report, okay, we're doing good for the year 2020 despite of the pandemic. We were able to generate this and that. We were able to cut expenses and spending, so on and so forth. So lahat yun, ano, those are some of the uses of accounting for internal users, para sa mga nasa loob ng company. Well, if you are outside, no, external users, sino ba yung mga tumitingin ng accounting records outside of the company? There are actually a lot of them. You have your investors, the lenders, suppliers, customers, tax authorities, government auditors, and even the public, no? Kaya nga, if you would Google accounting records for some companies, especially if they are publicly traded companies, it's published. Meaning, kahit sinong Juan or Pedro pwedeng mag-search online and look for the tax information, right? Of course, tax authorities, later on, I'll go in detail about that. You have your customers, pwede rin nilang tingnan yan, ano? Investors, why? Because they will be investing money in your company, of course. They wanted to make sure that the company is in good position or the company is profitable. The company is worth investing for. Alangan naman maglagay ako ng pera dyan and then malulugi lang tayo, right? So, those are some of the things that external users are covered when it comes to reviewing accounting information. Like what I have said earlier, auditors and tax authorities are looking into accounting information and they are external users. Like for example, you have BIR. So BIR, that is the tax authority for the Philippines, right? So tinitingnan yung if you are paying your taxes correctly, if there are no tax fraudulence, something like that, magkano ba yung kinikita talaga ng company. So you also have commission on audit. No? When you say commission on audit, make sure that whatever is reflected in the books is really correct, accurate, no? And even COA is responsible for looking into irregularities and loopholes. Like for example, the issue right now with PhilHealth, no? It was COA who found that out or was able to look at it because of the records, no? So, yung COA looks at the spending, eh. And even at the accounting records of a business, okay? So you also have Securities and Exchange Commission, right? So when you register your business, of course, they would need to look at your accounting data or your records, accounting records. And then an example of an investor would be banks, like you have BDO, BPI, Security Bank. The reason why I added Security Bank in the example is because Security Banks offers 5 million pesos loans for small businesses. Okay, so if you're a small business, pwede kang kumuha ng loan sa kanila. And one of the requirements in order for them to grant the loan is to show the accounting records. Okay, because again, they cannot invest or put money in your business if it does not prove a possibility of earning income. Summary, here are some of the points that I would like you to retain as we end the first part or the first discussion of accountancy for grade 11 and grade 12 students. So regardless of the size of a business, accounting is necessary. Okay, it's necessary for decision making. So in order for bosses to be able to make decisions, makapag-isip sila, plan, measure, etc., they would need accounting information because you don't just trust your hunch, no? Even if they are seasoned or kahit magagaling na sila na businessman, they would steal numbers to prove or justify their decision. A bookkeeper can handle basic accounting needs, but a certified public accountant should be utilized for larger or more advanced accounting tasks. yan yung nabanggit ko kanina, no? That's why a certified public accountant earns more or even double of what a bookkeeper earns for entry level. Two important types of accounting for business are managerial accounting, cost accounting, and managerial accounting helps management teams make business decisions. So again, it all boils down to being able to make the decision, no? You have the owner, and then you have the employees, and then the manager is in the middle. They must be able to use the accounting very efficiently. And then finally, professional accountants follow a set of standards known as the GAAP when preparing financial statements. So there you have it. That wraps up the first discussion of accountancy and business management, or the fundamentals of ABM for grade 11 students. Again, you know, I want to encourage everybody, especially those in ABM, that huwag niyong katakutan ng accounting. Accounting is easy. You can do it, no? Kayang-kaya ninyo yan. If you have questions, you can message me directly. My links are in the description. You can also follow me on these platforms in order for you to see further lectures about this topic. Thank you so much for this opportunity, and to God be all the glory.